महाभारिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो वंश ऋषिभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपवृत्त प्रज्ञानधन प्रत्यगर्थो ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि नारायणं पद्मभूं वसिष्ठं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्र पराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौड़पदं महांतं गोविंद योगींद्रमथास्य शिष्यं श्रीशंकराचार्यमथास्य पद्मपादं च हस्तामलकं च शिष्यं दंतोटकं वार्तिककारमन्यान् अस्मद्गुरून् श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानामालयकरुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ वनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽपि अरिसहोदरापमहत्पदं तमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकजाङ्गमनन्तसुखाकृतिं यद्ब्रह्मगोचर विचित्रतमः प्रभावात् संसारधीजनितदुःखमभूज्जनस्य यद्ब्रह्मधीजनितसौख्यमभूच्च तस्य तं रुक्मिणीसहितकृष्णमहं नमामि। So we were looking at the Ratna Prabha Vakya where it said Amrutatva Kamina Advaita Atma Vichara Eva Vedanta Vakyehi Kartavyaha Iti. So what does it mean? The Tikakara said that Eva Karasya Uvayatra Anvayaha. सो अद्वैतात्म विचारः एव कर्तव्यः एंड वेदांत वाक्यैः एव सः विचारः कर्तव्यः। सो टू थिंग्स हैव बीन मेंशन्ड, विल सी व्हाट इट मींस इन द टीका अगेन, बट व्हाट आई लेफ्ट आउट, आई सेड दैट विल टॉक अबाउट विधीज, यस्टरडे आई डिडंट वांट टू टॉक अबाउट विधीज एंड एग्जांपल स्पेसिफिकली, बट एनीवे इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट टू नो एज टू व्हाट इज दिस विधि, which vidhi is applicable here. So tena kamyena niyama vidhina has been mentioned. So niyama vidhi, kamya vidhi all right, but niyama vidhi, kamya vidhi because there is amrutatva kama, there is kama towards amrutatvam, one wants to get moksha, which is freedom from birth and death. So cycle of birth and death goes away, therefore amrutatvam is what is the intention, what is the phala expected, sought after. Therefore kama is there. Although there is kama, this is not kamya karma type of kamya. So what does it mean, the meaning also, what is this kamya vidhi, that will also be explained, and niyama vidhi. So our focus right now is niyama vidhi. Why is this niyama vidhi? So in Purvamimamsaka, in Purvamimamsa, the Purvamimamsaka analyzes as to what are the types of vidhi. So there are three types of vidhis: Apurva vidhi, Niyama vidhi and Parisankhya vidhi. So what kind of vidhi is this? Amrutatva kamena advaita atma vichara eva kartavya and vedanta vakye eva kartavya. So Apurva vidhi I mentioned yesterday. So the example is Jyotishthomena Swarga Kamo Yajeta. So one who has Kama for Swarga should do Jyotishthoma Yaga. Now this Jyotishthoma Yaga as well as Swarga really is something which is not known outside of the Shastra. So it is Aprapta, unknown through any other means. So that is called as an Apurva Vidhi, which is not known purva, earlier. Then Niyama Vidhi Yesterday I mentioned Parisankhya Vidhi. In Niyama Vidhi and Parisankhya Vidhi also you have two options available. Pakshe, but Pakshe Prapte Niyama Vidhi, when two things are possible, two ways are possible, if the Shruti tells you do it in this way, then it is Niyama Vidhi, like in the current context. Parisankhya Vidhi also there are two things prapt, but they are not Paksha Prapta. So yesterday I may have mentioned Pakshe Prapte Parisankhya. It is not Pakshe Prapte Parisankhya. It is Pakshe Prapte Niyama Vidhi. I don't remember whether I said Niyama Vidhi or Parisankhya Vidhi. So if at all I said Parisankhya Vidhi, it's a correction. So I made a mistake yesterday. I don't remember what exactly I said. But Pakshe Prapte. In both there are two options available. But there is no Paksha Prapti in Parisankhya Vidhi. In the case of Parisankhya Vidhi, where does it apply? It applies when both are Yugapat Prapta. There are two options in both cases, in Niyama Vidhi as well as Parisankhya Vidhi, and therefore there is, I think in Siddhanta Lesha Sangraha, Bhagavan Appaya Dikshita analyzes this, and he takes a Purva Paksha as to Niyama Vidhi also looks like Parisankhya Vidhi. There he says, Itena Vachyam. You shouldn't say that. Why? Because there it is Yugapat Prapta. The example is a little, you know, Shastra example, Vaidika context, the example would be for Parisankhya Vidhi would be when, you know, with the, what is Raga Prapta? So Raga Prapta, you see in modern world, you see a lot of it. It is considered as, you know, as a way of life for many people. They eat all sorts of animals, anything that moves, they eat. Non-vegetarians. So, what kind of prani should not be eaten? So, there they, you know, the Shruti says, pancha pancha nakha, that kind of prani. So, there it is said as, let me open up the example itself. Just give me one moment. Here, so anyway, for the Niyama Vidhi itself, I'll mention the Shastri example. I didn't mention that. So, Swarga Kamo Yajeta is one, but then here it is Jyotish Tomena Swarga Kamo Yajeta. So that should be sufficient. Okay. Vreen Prokshati is the example given by in Siddhanta Lesha Sangraha. But anyway, for the Parisankhya Vidhi, the example is as to five, if there are. It's the example, just give me one moment. I didn't want to cover this, but then it is important for to know what is what exactly is this Niyama Vidhi. So Jyotish Tomena Swarga Kamo Yajeta, and then so I just mentioned what is the Niyama Vidhi yesterday with the example of the Vrihi. I'm able to find this. Can you skip this? I don't remember the exact mantra, but anyway, you get the idea. Pancha Pancha Nakha, which has, you know, five nails, those kind of pranis can be eaten. So that's what it means. What it means is that it is not prescribing as to you eat that. It's not saying that you consume animals. It is nowhere saying that. But what is it saying? It appears that it is saying so. So what is the vidhi all about there? The vidhi there is to take away what is simultaneously prapta, ragataha. So somebody has raga towards here it is, I think. Pancha pancha nakha bhakshyaha. So pancha pancha nakha bhakshyaha, there it is bahurihi, those which have pancha pancha nakhas, those kind of animals are bhaksha. So there is kritya pratyaya is used. So someone may think, oh, I have to consume this. No, you don't have to. Since there is ragata praptaha and driven by hunger, one may eat anything that moves. There it says that you give up the others. So if somebody is drawn to eat others, that's why, you know, this gohatya is all prohibited. But then people have raga to consume it. So it's all papa karma. Because of this vakya, you should not consume anything else. That is the meaning there. It is not saying that you consume this. If at all you have to consume, anyway you are going to consume. Because you have ragata prapta, simultaneously I will eat anything that moves. So this is what these people think. Then the Shruti says, do not eat those. How does it say? By saying that pancha pancha nakha bhakshya. This is parisankhya vidhi, which is yugapat prapta. Simultaneously there is raga towards consuming all sorts of, you know, the all sorts, anything that moves rather. Let me just put it that way. I don't want to use the word there. So that being the case, there parisankhya vidhi is applicable. Now in this case, niyama vidhi, where is niyama vidhi applicable? So in niyama vidhi's case, when the Shruti says that there is a, in Purudasha, so it is made from rice. That rice has to be offered. Now when you remove the skin, this is what I mentioned, as to when the skin is removed, that time what do you use? So there is a possibility to, I said dehusk, actually there is no, not dehusking, husking itself means removing the skin. So to remove the husk, the English language says that, you know, husking is the verb there. So you can husk it by, you know, stamping it with the pole, or it can be removed by any machinery or with your fingers, with the nails, or it can be, you know, with rubbing against two stones, you can husk the grains. However, it should be. So now here it is. Prapta, but not simultaneously. Both are prapta, just like in the case of parisankhya vidhi, but here there is a vidhi, there is a positive instruction. You should do this. What should you do? Not saying that you shouldn't do anything else. That is in parisankhya vidhi. Here it is saying you should do only in this way. So you should do it, and you should do it only in this way. This is the niyama vidhi. So there is a niyama, there is a rule that you have to follow this way, and there is a vidhi, it has to be done. So you cannot just put it with the skin. So now we have three options. Which one is this vidhi of yours, where you say amrutatva kavina advaita atma vicharaha eva kartavyaha vedanta vakye eva kartavyaha? It is not apurva vidhi. Because when, if one knows Vyakrana, because Sangha, there is a study, is the, along with Vedangas, the Veda Shakha has been studied. Therefore, one will get the idea that the meaning of Shravana is what? Shravana Kartavya, Kartavyatvam is there. So, the Vichara is automatically there. Nonetheless, it is possible to do, even if you know it as Vichara, is possible, then how to do this vichara? Should I do it independently, or should I do it using Shruti Vakyas, Vedanta Vakyas, Upanishad Vakyas, or should I do it with Purana Vakyas, and so on? So all these options are available. So you can do it in one way or the other. That time the Shruti says you have to do it only in this way. That is the Evakara, and therefore Niyama Vidhi is applicable, not Parisankhya Vidhi or Apurva Vidhi. So this is the clarity I wanted to bring in, because this is going to help later. There is a huge difference in taking what kind of a vidhi. If you don't take it as a niyama vidhi and take it as a parisankhya vidhi, then it means you don't do anything else. So this is not ordained really, which would mean that you can, you know, be okay without doing any of this. That's not the purpose. The purpose is for moksha. This is all this is what has to be done, and this is the only way it has to be done. For whom? For one who has adhikara in Veda Shravana. Others, for others, Purana and the other means are there. They are also there. They will generate paroksha jnana, and those who have samskara from the earlier janma, if they are Kalyanakruta, as Bhagavan Gita Acharya says, then they can get aparoksha jnana through Purana Ityadi also. That's an exception. But here we are talking about general rules. Exceptions like Vamadeva also, one may get jnana in the womb itself. Garbhavasa itself is sufficient to take away the obstacles, and the jnana, shravana, which was done in the earlier janma, that itself can lead to mukti. Or there are examples, you know, as to in childhood itself, somebody without any study got, you know, jnana, like Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi. Not everyone can be Ramana Maharshi, not everyone can try and become Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi, because if you really want to gain jnana without doing anything, like the example of Bhagavan Ramana or Bhagavan Vamadeva, then you should have got jnana in the garbha or in childhood. What does that mean? It means that without shravana you cannot get it. And if you have done shravana in the earlier janma, it is not sufficient, or the obstacles are more than they had. Therefore, we all have to do shravana ityadi as sadhanas for moksha. Therefore, advaitatma vichara eva kartavya, Vedanta vakya eva kartavya. So, dvaita vichara should not be done. That's what it means by advaita atma vichara. Atma as separated from Ishvara, other jivas, etc., is not the way the vichara should be done. That vichara should be countered by the Vaikya Shruti. Similarly, not if you have adhikara in Vedas, Veda Shravana, then only through Vedanta Vakyas should you do Shravana and Vichara. Vichara, not Shravana. Shravana meaning here is going to be shown as Vichara. Okay. So now let's move on further into what does the Tika says. So Vicharo Nama. What is Vichara? Vicharo Nama. Uhapohatmaka Manasa Kriyarupas Tarkaha. So many people have allergy to Tarka. Oh, Tarka should not be studied. Tarka will take you away. Yes. It will take you away if you focus only on Tarka, but without Tarka, Manana is not possible, and Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasana is the way to Moksha. Shravana will lead to Moksha by itself only when Manana is done to remove the obstacles in the forms of Samshayadi. So if one has doubtful knowledge, even if the best of the Guru teaches, it is not going to yield results, because obstacles are there. How do you take away the obstacles? If the Sadhana Chatushta Sampatti is not complete, in complete measure in sense, enough to take away the obstacles, then obstacles will remain even during and after Shravana. Therefore, Nididhyasana is needed, and Nididhyasana is possible only when one has conviction in Advaita Atma Jnana. That conviction won't come if doubts are pending. Therefore, Manana is needed, and Manana, whether we like it not, is Tarka. You will need logic there. It is not Shushka Tarka, because you are tracing it back to Shruti. Just Tarka, if one gets lost into, then that becomes primary and says, I will do it. You can't do it. How will anyone conclude anything without Shruti telling you Aikya? Therefore, it is Shruti Moolaka Tarka. And what kind of Tarka is it? Uha Pohatmaka Manasakriya. It is Manasa Kriya Rupa Tarka. So you don't have to, you know, go and in debate in Vidvat Sabhas. One may or may not do it, but then it should be Manasa Kriya Rupa Tarka. One should be thinking and concluding to convince oneself and remove doubts. So Uha Pohatmaka is what should be done, what should not be done. What should be taken up, what should be given up. Nitya Nitya Vastu Viveka. So Viveka is included there as to what should I hold on to, in what meaning should I hold on to, what should I drop, where should I apply Jahal Lakshana, where should I apply Ajahal Lakshana, in Bhagatyaga or Jahad Ajahal Lakshana, what should I hold on to, what should I drop. All this is part of Tarka. So this is the simplest of the examples, but then it will all depend on what the samshaya is. Evakarasya ubhayatranvaya, we saw that Vedanta Vakyareva Vichara Ityanena Stri Shudradinam Puranadi Shravanena Parokshameva Jnanam Jayate Tena Janmantare Vedanta Shravane Adhikaraha Tena Aparoksha Jnanam Ityarthopi Gamyate. So the general rule is that there are only specific people qualified for Veda study, or others have exemptions also. So the punya is divided between the husband and wife, although the husband alone is doing the karma, and they say that the husband has, the man has the adhikara in Veda Shravana Ityadi and Vaidika karma in Karma Kanda. Now whatever he is doing as Ardhangani, she is involved there. Without the marriage, he wouldn't have adhikara in the karma itself. He would have adhikara in only in Agni Kriya, not in Agni Hotra Ityadi. Therefore, when he is doing the karma, the wife is by the side for Sankalpa, etc. And then culturally, the woman has a lot of other responsibilities. The nature has also entrusted the woman with more responsibilities than the man in household matters. Like carrying the garbha, bringing up the children, teaching the children, giving them samskara, etc. All these, I mean, and then of course everything else as to supporting the ritual in many ways. And of course, since the husband is busy throughout the day, should be supposed to be busy throughout the day in karma, so he has to be fed. That is also going to fall on the lady of the house. So anyway, that is all cultural that you know, but I am just buffering this as to somebody may see, you know, what is this mentioned, Shri Stri Shudra Adhinam. So, Traivarnikas have Yajnopavita, therefore they have Adhikara in Vedas. The others have Adhikara in Moksha. So, the difference is in whether or not one should be doing karma. Not every activity, whether can or not is one thing, but whether it should be done by the man and the woman, both. Just because a woman does something, the man cannot do it, and vice versa. Because Ishvara created them as different. They are not the same. They cannot be the same. They need not be the same. The focus is moksha. If the focus is moksha, how does it matter whether one gets moksha through one way or the other way? Jnanena moksha, but that jnana, what is the source of that jnana, whether it is diluted for me or I am given something difficult to chew on, it is irrelevant to the end goal. So, keeping that in mind, you should read this, understand this as Vedanta Vakyare Vichara Ichyanena Stri Shudrajna Puranadi Shravanena. Because of a busy day, they can't participate in Vedanta Shravana and activities, Veda Patha, where there should be continuous chanting. And of course, Ashaucha also is a part of life. So, which is applicable to the man also in the case of something happens in with relatives, etc., family and relatives, death in the family, birth in the family, all this will bring ashaucha. But then bodily ashaucha is there, which will go away by daily snana. You cannot sit for ritual when there is ashaucha. Similarly, for a woman, there is more. Anyway, thereby Puranadi Shravana can be done by anyone, any point of time. Therefore, everyone is involved in that, including this person who is doing the karma, Vaidika karma. However, for that person, what is said is that you don't need to go and do that. What should you do for moksha? You should do vichara using Vedanta Vakya. So, one who has adhikara is being told that you give up the Purana Shravana. Not that you shouldn't do it, you should do only Vedanta vichara for moksha. So, it is not denying others. And others who have samskara, even if they do Vedanta Vichara and they have, even if they do Puranadi Shravana and they have done Vedanta Vichara in the earlier life, and this Janma as a Shudra, as a Stri or as a Purusha also, in who has no qualification in Vedas because Upanayana Samskara is not there, or being there also it is just there to scratch your back. You know, there are many people who use Yajnopavita only to scratch their back. Pooja Swamiji used to, you know, laugh at you giving such examples. Then that person should do what? He will also get moksha if there is Purva Samskara using Puranadi. But otherwise, if there is an adhikara in Vedanta Shastra, you do that. This is what is the meaning as to, because for considering that you do not have puro samskara of that depth, generally we, otherwise we wouldn't have been born and involved in this kind of a lifestyle in this kind of an era of Kali Yuga. Therefore, what I said is a general rule is that they will give you only paroksha jnana. For aparoksha jnana, one will have to do Vedanta Shravana in some life. Whether if one has done in the earlier lives, then with Puranadi Shravana also, whoever that is, whether it is a Shudra, Stri or a Brahmana, they will all get moksha. They can get moksha. But general rule is that through Vedanta Shravana, and assuming that one has not done in the earlier lives, one may have done everything else but not Vedanta Shravana, so one will continue here with this Janma with Adhikara in Veda Shastra and then have Ruchi also there and understand it as well and thereby get Aparoksha Jnana. Tena Janmantari Vedanta Shravana Adhikara. Otherwise, if one has not done in the earlier life and this life also, then whoever it is will get Janma for Vedanta Shravana and thereby Aparoksha Jnana. Tena Aparoksha Jnana Mityarthopi Gamyate. This is, Gamyate means this is understood, this is an inference, this is an Anumana using this Evakara. Evakara with Deli Deepan Nyaya. So much technicality is involved here. Advaita Atma Vichara Eva Vichyanena Dvaita Shastra Vicharo Nirasyate. One shouldn't do Vichara in Dvaita, which I mentioned in the Mula, based on the Tika itself. Mula as in Ratna Prabha, based on Purnanandiya. Vedanta Vakyer Eva Vichyanena. So, with the Evakara having Anvaya in the earlier part of the sentence, Dvaita Vichara shouldn't be done. Vedanta Vakyer Eva Ichyanena, and with the Evakara having Anvaya with the second part of the following part of the sentence, Vedanta Vakyer Eva Ichyanena, Vaidikanam Puranadi Pradhanyam Nirasyate Iti Vibhagam Avipretya. So, Puranadi Pradhanyam Kesham Nirasyate, for whom it has been said that you should do Vichara only through Vedanta Vakya. For whom has it been said? For Vaidikas, not for Avaidikas. For those who have no Adhikaras in Vedas, they can continue to do Purana study. But there are many people, you look at Dvaitins or others, Advaitins also. But namesake Advaitins, because entire commitment is in studying Purana. Oh, this is very interesting. This is, you know. So they are interested more in glories. Not that they'll not get Advaita Jnana, because every Shastra is committed to the Tatpare Vishaya of the Shruti, which is Aikya. However, one can get lost in this. So as a jovial example, somebody had said, you know, the Guru asked after the entire Ramayana Katha, teaching Ramayana to the students, then he says, oh, which is the character you liked? What did you like the most in Ramayana, or who did you like the most? So one chap came up and said that, I like Jatayu. So what is Jatayu's role? How much is the role in the entire Ramayana? Dharma Shastra, Dharma Purusha Rama, he likes Jatayu. So people are lost in what they like. Jokingly called as Paramananda Shishya. So they are in their own world of Ananda. They will get what they get. Thereby, what will their focus be? It will be in something else than the Tatpare Vishaya of the Puranas also. So they'll start praising, oh Shiva, Shiva Purana, I love Shiva, everyone else is. Then they'll fight with others as to Shiva is the greatest. Others will say Vishnu is the greatest, Vaishnavas, and then they'll fight with Shiva, because their Vaishnava Puranas are glorifying. Basically, they are glorifying the Ishta Devata so that they can have some bhakti, not for the Ninda of the others. It is a Nahi Nindyana. Thereby, Vaidikanam Puranadi Pradhanyam Nirasyateti Vibhagam Avipretya. So since there are two options possible, Pakshe Prapte Vibhagam Avipretya Niyama Vidyangikare Phalitam Arthamaha, then what is the resultant when you take it as Niyama Vidhi Mula? So Ratna Prabha Vyakhya says, so I'll just say Bhashya, Vyakhya and Tika, so that it is easier. So what you have to refer to when Bhashya, then it is Adhyasa Bhashya. Vyakhya will be Ratna Prabha, Bhashya Ratna Prabha, and Tika means the Purnanandiya. So Vyakhya, Tena Kamyana Niyama Vidina Arthadeva Bhinnatma Shastra Pravruttihi Vaidikanam Puranadi Pradhanyam Va Nirasyateti Vastugati. So Vastugati, what is the reality here? What is the understanding with this Shrotavyaha Vidhihi or others? So Anveshtavyaha, Savijijnyasitavyaha, Atmavare, Drashtavya, Shrotavyaha, Ityadi. And all that comes in from Swadhyaya Vadhyetavya, because one is doing one's Swashaka study, one of these mantras will fall on one's ears, and thereby Vichara Eva Kartavya, Vedanta Vakki Eva Kartavya, that is the meaning of Shrotavya. Now, Tena Kamyena Niyama Vidhina, due to this Kamya Vidhi and being a Niyama Vidhi, Arthadeva means other kinds of Vidhis are not applicable here. Parisankhya Vidhi is taken away, it is not Apurva Vidhi. So, Parisankhya Vidhi, can it be? No, it isn't. Therefore, Arthadeva's implication is this, that's the meaning. Bhinnatma Shastra Pravrutti Vaidikanam Puranadi Pradhanamya Nirasyate Iti Vastugati Hi. This would be the meaning also of Parisankhya Vidhi, but then positively it wouldn't be saying that Advaita Atma Vichara Eva Kartavya Vedanta Vakya Eva Kartavya. Therefore, it is a Niyama Vidhi. Tatra, there is a comment there. So, Tika says as to Vidhi, so Artha, Parisankhya Vidhi Bhedam Nyapayati. Tena iti. So, Phalitam Arthama Tena iti. Tena iti Tritiya Samanadi Karana. So, Tena, there, Tena Niyama Vidhina. It's in Samanadi Karana. That's what is mentioned there, meaning both are talking about the same adhikarana, that same vidhi, tena vidhina and niyama vidhina. Tena iti tritiya samanadhikarana vidhe kamyatvam nama. Now it is said that kamya vidhi, tena kamyena niyama vidhina. So tena kamyena niyama vidhina, all these are in samanadhikaranya. What does it mean? It means that through that kamya vidhi, which is a niyama vidhi, through that Kamya Niyama Vidhi, what is known, that is the Arthad, etc. So, Vidhe Kamyattam Nama, what do you mean by Kamya Vidhi? Is it same as Kamya Karma? No, Vidhe Kamyattam Nama, Kamana Vishaya Sadhana Bodhakattvam. So, what does Kamya Vidhi mean? It means that if the Amrutattva Kama is there, this person is an Amrutattva Kama, meaning there is Kama towards Amrutattvam Moksha, then what is the means? That is revealed here. Shrotavya. So, Shrotavyam. Shrotavya is the vidhi there. Atma va are Shrotavya. Saha Anveshtavya. Vichara Kartavya. Vedanta Vakyai Kartavya. These are the means for what? For Amrutattvam. That is the idea. So, it reveals the sadhana for the Kamana Vishaya, which is Amrutattvam. Paksha Praptase Aprapta Paripurana Phalako Vidhihi Niyama Vidhir Ityartha. This we have already seen. More detail than you would want it. So you would want to move ahead, but then this part was important, so I spent a lot of time on that. Parisankhya vidhi bhedam nyapayati. So arthaditi, by that the parisankhya vidhi application is taken away. There's a difference in niyama vidhi. Vidhi pratipadya vicharasya vidhi sannihita vedanta vakyakangsha satvena Puranadi Pradhanyadehe Nirakangshatvad Ichartha. So, Arthad, so what is the implication? Vidhi Pratipadya Vicharasya. The Vichara, which is the meaning of Shrotavya Vidhi, along with that, there will be Vedanta Vakyas, because it has occurred in the Upanishad Jnanakanda. So, Shrotavyaha is in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, and Brihadaranyaka Upanishad is huge. Similarly, each of the Upanishad will have something similar to this Vidhi, or it will be attained through some other Upanishad, and then the rest of the Upanishad is for what purpose? It is close because it is in the Upanishad. Upanishad Antargata Mantrena, one knows as to Vidhi Pratipadya Vichara is there. So, Vichara Kartavya, Maya Kartavya, Maya Amrutattva Kamyena Maya, Esha Vichara Kartavya. Kimartham? Amrutattvartham. Therefore, one wants Amrutattvam for Moksha, one should do Vichara. And then Vichara of what? Shravana of what mantra? And Vichara on what mantra? Upanishad mantra, not Puranadi shlokas. Therefore, Vidhisannita Vedanta Vakya Akanksha Satvena. There will be Akanksha. Kasya Shravanam Kartavyam Maya. Kasya Vichara Kartavya. Therefore, every other vakya which is there in the Upanishad, avantar vakya va bhavatu, avantar vakyam va bhavatu, mahavakyam va bhavatu, all that is in Upanishad itself. Therefore vidhi sannihita it is all near the shrotavya vidhi itself, or some other mantra where it says you do this, then tattvamasi has been mentioned in the same Upanishad. So it, in Chandogya Upanishad it is mentioned, so there will be some vidhi there as to shrotavya. So he, it is all Upanishad Jnanakanda. If you take it the entire as Jnanakanda itself as one unit and say that, oh shrotavya vidhi, what should I hear? You should not go back to Karmakanda, you should not go to Upasana sections, you should not go to Puranadi, you should stick with Upanishad, because vidhi as per Purvamimamsaka the phala and arthavada and the sadhana, all these will be mentioned in the same section. If it is not there, you go outside and look at something similar associated with. That's why it is Mimamsa, and Uttara Mimamsa cannot be different from Purvamimamsa. It is Shabda analysis. What is the Vakya Bodha finally? Sadhana is Vedanta Vakya Vichara, and thereby I'll get the phala of Amrutattvam. Therefore, Akanksha is resolved. Akanksha Satvena, there is an Akanksha. Kim Kartavyam Maya? Kasya Shravanam Kartavyam? Iti Akanksha Satvena, what should he do? Vidhi Sannita Vedanta Vakya Shravana he should do. Thereby Puranadi Pradhanyadehe Nirakangshatvad Ityartha, and thereby there won't be any Akanksha of study of Puranadi and doing Vichara there. Vashabdash Charthe. So here Va Shabda has been used there. Va Nirasyate. So there Va is in the sense of Cha. So Va Shabda Ha Cha Iti Artha, not Cha Iti, Cha Artha Yasya. Cha Artha Yasya Va Shabdasya Saha Va Shabda Ha Chartha Ha Tasmin Arthe Chartha. So it is in the meaning of and, not or. It is not that, Dvaita Vichara or Puranadi Vichara has been refuted, but both have been refuted. Therefore, Va should be understood as in the meaning of and. Vastugati means Vastavikam Jnanam. This is the Vastugati. This is the Vastavika Jnanam. There is no other way out. This is the way out. Atma Vichara Eva Kartavyaha Vedanta Vakyair Eva Kartavyaha. So this is the final conclusion. Without this, this sutra will not be useful. Tathacha uktarthe sarvesham vaidikanam pramatmaka nischayeva na sandhyayati bhava. Thereby, one will be convinced. There has to be conviction at every stage. What should I do? Should I do this? Should I do that? No, only this you should do. Thereby, sandeha na bhavati nischayeva bhavati. Pramatmaka nischaya. Prama, what is the Prama Janya here? Janya Prama is that Vedanta Vakya Reva Advaita Atma Vichara Eva Kartavyaha. So that is the complete sense. Tatra iti. So Tatra is introduced by saying Shravana Vidhi Shravana Vidha Upalabhyamane Sati Ityartha. Tatra means Tasmin Sati Saptami. Tasmin Vidha Upalabhyamane Sati. Since this vidhi is applicable, and when this vidhi is applicable, what is the resultant? Tatra iti. Upalabhe hetu maha. Since this vidhi is available, thereby adhikari is also available. Tatra. So, vyakhya. Tatra kaschid iha janmani janmantare va anushtita yajnyadi vhir nitantam nirmala swantaha asya shravana videhe ko vishayaha kim phalam कह अधिकारी ही कह संबंध इति जिज्ञासते तम जिज्ञासु उपलब्धमानः भगवान बादरायणः तदनुबंध चतुष्टयम् श्रवणात्मक शास्त्रारंभ प्रयोजकम् न्यायेन निर्णेतुम् इदं सूत्रम् रचयांचकार अथातो ब्रह्म जिज्ञासा इति. So somebody who is kaschit, so not everyone will get this curiosity at the bare minimum as to what is the Anubandha Chatushtaya for this Shrotavya. So somebody will get it, everyone hears it, but then many are drawn towards what can I get next, through which I'll get Vishaya Sukha. So there will be very few people. Kachit Dhira, as said in Katopanishad. Sorry if I'm yelling, but there is a lot of rain here, so I can't hear myself so clearly, so I have to be a little loud. So let me close the window. Whether in this janma or in earlier janma, one would have had these questions as to anushtita yajnyadivhi nitantam nirmala swanta. Who is this kashchit dhiraha? This person has done lot of karma yoga. He has done ordained yajnas, etc. And thereby, through karma kanda, he has got Nirmala Swa Antakarana. Anta is Antakarana. Nirmala Swanta. Yasya. So Nirmalaha Swantaha Antakaranam Yasya. And not just a little Nirmala here, or Nirmala is in not completely Nirmala, it isn't. Not that idea. Nitantam. It remains so. So what, at one point of time everyone feels, after taking a bath you feel fresh. Oh, I feel really fresh. The body gets, by the very nature of the body, it starts, losing this purity that you feel that you have after taking a bath. Similar, the antakkarana also. Antakkarana will keep on going through phases of, I feel very pure in my mind, but then some impure thought or something comes in, and then you feel, anger, kama, krodha, raga, dvesha, all this, the day is filled with this. Not that kind of a person. Why? Nitantam. It is to a great extent and it remains so. That kind of a person, asya shravana videhe shrotavyaha, has been said. Asya shravana videhe ko vishaya kim phalam ko adhikari kasambandha iti jijnyasate. So he'll have jijnyasa, jnatum, ichha is there as to what is the vishaya, what is the anubandha chatushtaya. Tam jijnyasum upalabhamanaha bhagavan badarayanaha. So this badarayana vyasa, who is bhagavan? How does he know that such an adhikari exists? Be it few, there are few such adhikaris for whom I should create these sutras. Starting with athato brahma jijnyasa, ataha brahma jijnyasa kartavya, kena amritatva kamina. So one who has amritatva kama, he should do vichara using Vedanta Vakya. But who is this? What is his vishaya? Who is the adhikari? What is his subject matter? What is the phala he'll get? What is the sambandha between this vichara or the sutra, Brahma Sutra study, and then vichara thereby, which is in the Shruti? What is the sambandha there? All sorts of questions would come up about Anubandha Chatushtaya. Therefore, Bhagavan Badarayanaha tad anubandha chatushtayam, which is what? Shravanatmaka shastrarambha prayojakam. Without this, no shastra can be created, whether it is some prakarana grantha or the sutra. So to create the sutras, which will tell you what is the purpose of the shruti vidhi there, as to shrotavyaha, what should you be doing there? There has to be anubandha chatushtaya there. And the same Anubandha Chatushtaya is in the Sutra also. So who is it targeting? What is the target audience there? What is the subject matter to which he should listen to and do vichara on? What is the phala he'll get from doing that? And what is the sambandha among these? Now how does Badarayana Vyasa know that there are such adhikaris available? Therefore Bhagavan. So that is mentioned in the, and further in the sentence it is Nyayena, Nyayena Niranetum. It should be established. Just by saying it, the mind will be, questioning. Why does he say that this is the only way? There are other ways. I am a Karma Yogi, Karma Yoga will give Moksha. I am a Yogi, I will get Moksha in Samadhi. Or someone may say, help others. You help others. Yes, you help others. That is all true. You do karmakanda, yajna, that will give you moksha? No. You help others, will that give you moksha? Directly, no. Kramena, yes, all of these are there. Dharmakarya will lead to chitta shuddhi. Samadhi will also lead to obstacles dropping off. It will also give you first-hand conviction if you are not convinced that you are the Ananda Swarupa in Sushupti. If you are not convinced, because Ananda is very difficult. The day is filled with Dukkha. Day in, day out there is Dukkha. There is some Sukha here or there, which keeps life ticking. But then the question comes back, how can I be Ananda Swarupa? The mind will be struggling so much if someone says that your Swarupa is Ananda. Pooja Swami would say, Poda. So, won't work. So, there the person has to have Chitta Shuddhi. Thereby, all this will help a person to get Chitta Shuddhi, but by itself it won't lead to Mukti. Samadhi will tell you that you are Ananda Swarupa. So this person is, no, in Sushupti, I don't know whether I had Ananda. So very argumentative and logically failing as well. There are people who say that in how do you prove that? So they want logical proof. Although it is Anubhava Siddha, they want logical proof there, to prove their own Anubhava. So they want someone else to use logic to prove their Anubhava, Anubhava itself. It is ridiculous because Anubhava is Pratyaksha. You cannot prove Pratyaksha to someone else or otherwise using Anumana which has a dependency on Pratyaksha Anubhava. So very ridiculous ideas are there because they think that the Buddhi is so sharp, they say, no, I will even discard my Anubhava. You have to prove that in Sushupti I had Ananda. How will you prove? No logic is working. So you tell, okay, you know, practice yoga and get Samadhi Anubhava, then you will know that you have Ananda Swarupa. The Samadhi Anubhava is not a joke. So the same tricky mind will come and question as to how can I know that, you know, in Samadhi. Won't even want to practice Ashtanga Yoga. So none of these Angas will work. The Bahirangas won't work. Antaranga Sadhana is impossible. Samadhi is a dream. So just criticizing Samadhi will also not work. So anyway, Tatra iti, Shravana Vidhi Upalabhyamane Sati Ityartha Upalambe Hetuma. How is it that this Shravana Vidhi is available for an Adhikari? How does he know? Because he is Bhagavan. That is the idea. So Bhagavan, what is the meaning of Bhagavan? Here, why Badarayanaha Vyasa created these sutras? He created because Anubandha Chatushta is there. There are some Adhikaris for whom it will be useful. How does he know? Because he is Bhagavan. And how does he know because he is Bhagavan? How do you say so? How does Bhagavan prove that Badarayana Vyasa knew, Vyasacharya knew that such utility is there? Utpattincha vinashancha bhutanam agatim gatim vetti vidyam avidyancha savachyo bhagavan iti. Iti bhagavat shabdartha. What is the meaning of Bhagavan? Bhaga asya asti iti Bhagavan. What kind of Bhaga? He knows Utpatti and Vinasha. Bhutanam Agatim Gatim. So he knows how this Prapancha has come about. Utpatti and Vinasha of everything, anything and everything. He is Hari himself. You see, we have seen in the Mangalacharana. Vyasam Harim Vande. And he knows all the Bhutas, Bhuta Prapancha as well as Bhutas in Pranis. He knows their Agatim Gatim. He knows what each and so because Ishwaratvam is there, Aishwarya is there, Veti Vidyam Avidyancha, he knows Vidya also, he knows Avidya also. That kind of an entity, Sahavachya Bhagavan iti. That kind of Bhagavan knows, Vyasacharya knows as to whom it will be useful for, therefore it is, you know, Yogi Pratyaksha. What is Badarayana, Badaraha, Badari Vriksha, Yasmin Deshe Santi? Sa desha visheshu badaraha sa eva enam sthanam yasya sa badarayana shri vedavyasa atras. So vedavyasa has been called as badarayana vyasa. Why badarayana? Because he was born in a place where there are lot of badari vrikshas. So tasmin deshe, in that desha he was born. So desha vishesha is badaraha, where there are more, so you know, plum like fruits, what they call as a jujub or something. So where he is, you know, Badrinath. So in that kind of a place he was born. Therefore, Saheva, Sabadraeva, Ayanam Yasya Sthanam, Ayanam is Sthanam. So that is the place, Desha, where he was born, and he, you know, spent quite a lot of his Brahma Sutra creation there. Therefore, he is called as Badarayana. He hails from that place otherwise. Sabadarayana Shri Vedavyasa Ityartha. Atra, then if you use a yogic artha, meaning you derived meaning if you have used, then the derived meaning, there are a lot of kitas also born there. So they will also get the name Badarayana. No, it won't work so. Why? Because Natvam. Atra Sanyatvat Natva Praptya. This Nakara has become Nakara. Ayana, Ayana Nakara has become Nakara. Why has it become Nakara? So in Vyakarana you know there as Rashabhyam Nonaha Samanapade Atkupvang Num Yavayipi etc. There, this Natvam is in Samanapada, but this Natvam, Nakara becoming Nakara, Badarayana has become Badarayana. Thereby you know it is Sanya. It is not Yogikartha, simply Yogikartha, otherwise it would have remained Badarayana. So you can call the Kita etc. born there in Badara Kshetra as Badarayana, but then Sanyatva, this is the Sanya, this is the name for Bhagavan Vyasacharya, therefore it has taken Natvam. Natva Praptya, Kitadi Vyavrittir Bodhya. So you should understand that it is not applicable to anyone and anything which is born in Badara Desha, but it is specifically only for Bhagavan Vyasacharya. Taditi. Then what has been said? Tad Anubandha Chatushtayam Shravanatmaka Shastraramba Prayojakam. So Tikakara says, Taditi. Jijnyasa Vishayi Bhutam Ityartha. What is the Vishay of this Jijnyasa? This Anubandha Chatushtaya. Therefore, Jijnyasa Vishayi Bhutam Ityartha. Shravanadhyatmakam Shastram has been mentioned. So, Shravanadhyatmaketi, Shravanadhyatmakam Yat Shastram Tasya Arambha Pravruttihi Tasmin Prayojakam Karanam Ityartha. So, Shravanadhyatmaka Shastra Prayojaka was mentioned. So, Prayojaka is Nul Pratyanta, Kartari. Kartari Nul. So, in Shravanadhyatma, Atma is Swarupa. Shravanadhya Swarupa Shastra which is there, that Shastra Arambha should be done. How can it be done? So, Arambha is Pravritti. How will the Adhikari or the Sadhaka have an Adhikari, have Pravritti? How will the Sadhaka or the one who has done Shravana of this Shrotavya Mantra, how will he have Pravritti towards Shastra? Which Shastra? Which should be done Shravana about? So he will have Pravritti only when the Anubandha Chatushtaya is known. Therefore, the Anubandha Chatushtaya is Prayojaka, is that which will lead him to Pravritti Arambha of the Shastra. And this is applicable in the case of Brahma Sutras also. Shravanadi Bodhaka Shabdatmaka Shravanadi Bodhaka Shabdatmakatvat Shastrasya Shravanadhyatmakatvam iti bhavaha. So why is this Shastra called as Shravanadhyatmaka? What is the Shravana Swarupa there of the Shastra? Because Shravanadi Bodhaka Shabdatmakatvat. Since this Shrotavya has been mentioned, therefore Shravana Vidhi is there. It reveals that you should do Shravana. Therefore, it is because it is revealing the Shabda is revealing the Shravana should be done. That Shravana should be done. Therefore, it is called as Shravanadhyatmaka, Shravanadi Swarupa Shastra. Evam Uttaratra Vidyayam. And this should be known in other cases also. In the case of everywhere where Anubandha Chatushtaya is applicable, you have to understand this Anubandha Chatushtaya meaning. Nyayena iti and Nyayena Niranetum. Why should it be done Nyayena? It is in Prastharatraya, we know that Brahma Sutra, Shariraka Sutras are what? Nyaya Prasthana. Therefore, Nyayena Niranetum. What is this Nyayena Niranetum? Anubandha Chatushtaya Nyayena Niranetum in the Adhikaranas of the Sutras. So, you have Adhikaranas where some sections are grouped together, that will, some sections will have all Sutras grouped together, different numbers of course. Although the padas per chapter are same, but the adhikaranas are different and per adhikarana sutras are different. The grouping is based on what? It is based on particular set of nyaya used there. What is that? Nyayena Niranetum. विषयो विषयश्चैव पूर्वपक्षस्ततोत्तरं संगतिश्चेत चेति पंचांगम शास्त्रीय अधिकरणं स्मृतम्। सो दिस अधिकरणास विच आर 191 और 192 इन नंबर इन दी ब्रह्मसूत्रास। व्हाट इज एन अधिकरणा? द अधिकरणा इज दैट विच हैज विषया। विषया हियर इज तालव्य शकार शंकर शकार विषयः एंड विषयश्च वेयर यू हैव मूर्धन्य शकार विच इज षण्मुख शकार अदरवाइज। सो विषयः एंड विषय देयर इज अ डिफरेंस। विषय इज सब्जेक्ट मैटर विषय एज विषय इज संशय। सो वेयर देयर इज अ संशय वेयर देयर इज अ सब्जेक्ट मैटर रिगार्डिंग विच देयर इज अ संशय पूर्व पक्ष इज देयर वेयर देयर इज एन ओपोनेंट और अ ऑपोजिट व्यू countering view or an earlier view which has to be countered tatha uttaram the settlement of those answer to the purva paksha which will lead to samshaya nivritti also and sangatischa how it is connected in various ways to shruti or to how the sutra adhikarana is connected to other parts other adhikarana or to the subject matter itself or to the shruti. So there are various types of sangatis also. These five things, panchangam, these are the five factors which make adhikarana in the shastra. Shastri adhikarana smritam. So this is a smriti. Iti panchavaya upeta adhikaranatmaka nyayena ityartha. So what is the nyaya? He will be using this set of fives to conclude as to what are the set of shrutis saying. सूत्रमिति एंड व्हाट इज सूत्रमिति देयरफॉर ही क्रिएटेड दिस सूत्र अथा तो ब्रह्म जिज्ञासा आदि ऑनवर्ड्स ऑल दिस 555 सूत्र अल्पाक्षरम असंदिग्धम सारवद् विश्वतो मुखम अस्तोभम अनवद्यंच सूत्रम सूत्र विदो विदुः इति सूत्र लक्षणं विज्ञेयम्। सो यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दी डेफिनेशन लक्षण डेफिनेशन ऑफ द सूत्र एज व्हाट सो सूत्र कॉल्ड एज एफोरिज्म और व्हाटएवर व्हाट इज द लक्षण व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ सूत्र व्हाट इज fit to be called as sutra alpaksharam asandigdham. So it is alpakshara, it should have minimal set of words. Asandigdham, it should not be, you know, it should not lead to more and more sandeha. It should itself not be riddled with doubts. The sutra should have clarity. Saravat, and it should give the essence. It should not go into anything and everything. So it will be focusing on the essence, not on the, you know, the story. What you tell me, you know, mota, you tell me what is the, give me a big picture. So it will give you that essence. And then everyone, the vritti, the tika, the bhash, all these can elaborate this further, but then sutra itself should not be doing this. That is a sutra. And further what? Saravat vishvatomukham. And vishvatomukham means, although it is short, although it is an essence, it covers various facets. It covers almost everything that there is to cover in a very small manner. It is not a, you know, it is not a joke to create a sutra. That's the, you know, some may think that, okay, it's very short. What is there? So much is there, including Bhashya itself. Bhashya is treated like a sutra by Tikakaras by treating it as Moola. So much is there in the Bhashya itself. So imagine what is there in the sutra to elaborate. Endlessly, there are so many commentaries on it and sub-commentaries. So, Vishwatomukham, facing every aspect about the subject matter. Astobham anavadyam cha. So, it should be what? Astobham anavadyam cha. Astobham is mentioned here as to Samni ha-hu ityadyartha. रहित वर्णः स्तोव संज्ञकः। सो व्हाट इज स्तोव संज्ञकः? स्तोव इज दैट, यू नो व्हाट इज कॉल्ड एज स्तोव इज दीस अनर्थ शब्दास अनर्थ वर्णास। सो हा हु एटसेट्रा हा हु इट डज नॉट हैव अ स्पेसिफिक मीनिंग। साम देयर इज दिस, यू नो, इट इज संग and there are some letters varnas like ha hu. What is the meaning? If you inquire and you won't get meaning there. There is no meaning per se, but they will give you some adrashta. Therefore it has to be chanted in mantras also. If some are there to, while making offering etc., they may not have meaning. So if you look at meaning, then you won't be able to think straight as to, oh, I have to, why should I offer? So some doubts will come up. It will not give you punya, and it may even result in something else. Therefore, you stick to what has been prescribed. But these are not there in the sutra. So you don't have varnas which are meaningless. Every letter is meaningful in the sutra. Further, anavedyam. Anavedyam is it should not have faults. So it should be free from faults. That kind of a vakya is a sutra as per those who know the sutra. So sutra vidaha ye te viduhu. They say that so this is the lakshana of the sutra. I'll just finish this these two lines. अर्थवाद वाक्ये अधिकारी ज्ञातुं शक्यते कर्तव्यता रूप संबंधस्तु विधिना ज्ञातुं शक्यते विषय प्रयोजने तु उभयता ज्ञातुं शक्येते इत्यतः प्रथम सूत्रं व्यर्थम् इति शंकते ननु इति. सो आई जस्ट लीव विद दिस सेइंग दिस दैट द पूर्व पक्षी इज आस्किंग नाउ दिस अनुबंध चतुष्टय इज द रीजन फॉर विच अथा तो ब्रह्म जिज्ञासा सूत्र हैज बीन क्रिएटेड बाय भगवान बादरायण व्यासाचार्य. Now, if they can be known through other means, all the four, adhikari, vishaya, prayojana, and sambandha, then why do you need this sutra? So, he is showing that the sutra is unnecessary by pointing out that the adhikari, etc., or can be known, anubandha chatushtaya, can be known from shruti itself. So, you don't need this sutra. This is the objection. We'll look into it in the next part. यमिह कारुणिकं गतो यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽपि अरि सहोदर आप महत्पदं तमहम आशु हरिं परमाश्रय जनक जांगम अनंत सुखाकृतिं. एनी क्वेश्चंस
प्रवीण जी?
या
लक्षणा बस सूत्र
या अनवद्यम. अनवद्यम इज यू नो इट शुड नॉट हैव फॉल्ट्स. इट शुड बी फ्री फ्रॉम फॉल्ट्स.
From faults.
Arts means like? Faults means any fault. I mean, it should be free from errors. It should be error free.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah? Now, like you can't ask because like means what? In sutra, sutras are errorless. So, I can't give an example of sutra which has an error. It shouldn't have an error. That's the idea.
Thank you.
Okay. Anyone else? Anything else? Okay, namaste.
Thank you.